Hello, fellas. I hope you are feeling well and I hope you are ready for your the dose, which means a daily dose of skill. The dose. Yes, I'm reading your comments, fellas. Yes, I do. So here you go. And quick information for every single of you, what today's video is going to be all about and what is happening, because I believe some of you noticed the lags, right? So first of all, the lags. My computer is not behaving well. I did something wrong and I'm not IT specialist. I'm not computer guy. I don't even know specifics of my computer. So after this video, what I'm going to do, I'm demounting computer. I'm disconnecting the wires and I'm going to the computer specialist and I'm leaving computer for them to fix. So rebooting Windows, leaving everything inside and so on. And obviously clean the computer because of the vape cloud. So keep this in mind. So tomorrow we might have no video. This is one thing and quick information for every single of you, and believe me, I care about the quality and so on, and I needed to do that way earlier. Also, this is leading us for not having a stream today. I apologize, but this is going to be the thing. And right here, fellas, we are going to what I did yesterday. Yesterday I could not sleep during the night, right? So at 3 in the morning I was having some fun with my client mates Kapazander, Blitzwagen and In Ni. We had quite some fun playing this game mode, right? And I can tell you that it's close to impossible to win the random match. Even when we had four people platoon, which is speaking in the team speak and so on, usually the fifth guy was just going and dying, and that made our life 100% harder. And yesterday we played, if I'm not mistaken, 6 battles. And this is only one victory in those 6 battles. When we had a platoon out of 4 people, how people in the randoms playing it without any voice communication and anything, I don't know. Okay, anyways, I want to share that with you. You can see everything what we did. And my thoughts, my deeper thoughts about this game mode is very, very simple. First of all, tier 1s supposed to be matched only with the tier 1s, nothing more than that. No tier 2, no tier 3, because otherwise it's making their life way harder. So for example, our Blitzwagen and In Ni, which is the tier 1 of this nation, they need to deal with the 10 waves together when we are at tier 3. This is the thing. And big shout out for the Unhelks, which we met yesterday in this game mode. What happened? We, spoiler alert, we won this battle and immediately he invited us into platoon. Obviously we did not that was the last battle of the day, so we was not playing more with him, but he played very, very well. Anyways, what is happening right here and what we noticed in this map when we played when we played in platoon, right? One of the most important things is first of all, fellas, I believe you know you have every single collision or however it's called which you are picking, they have their different superpowers, right? I believe that makes sense, right? Also, fellas, I'm trying to figure out what do I want to say right here. Okay, listen. First of all, if we are speaking about this map, right, what do we want to have? We want to have some sniper schnitzels over there and make sure you are releasing your superpower smart, right? This is one of the most important things. And obviously, remember to take those ammunition icons, because your sniper schnitzels will need to have quite some ammunition, right? And now pay attention, what is this thing with which we played? This thing is pretty much giving us opportunity to spot all of them even without spotting them. And Arte Strikes is extremely useful against the Tigers or against the big amount of the Lemming train having guys, right? So what is happening right here, fellas? I activated this one and oh boy, the Tiger is having so much fun. You see? You see, the Tiger is enjoying himself. And obviously we are trying, the probably most important thing in this kind of stuff is to not lose any hit points whatsoever or try to survive this. Do I think it's easy? No. Fellas, imagine three guys which is, let's say like that, which knows what they are doing in the game, plus on top of that the random guy which played extremely well. We were struggling to win this, I can tell you that. We were struggling quite a bit. So I think the whole idea behind this this stuff was kind of good from Wargaming side, fellas. Because when you are playing with a platoon mates, when you are playing with a friends, this can be funny to play for some battles. But the most important thing is to change this game mode to pay to win mode, because you need to. The thing is, I can tell you that we had more fun than our two guys over there. Why? Because they was a tier 1 and they was playing with a tier 3 shitter, right? Meanwhile we was playing with a tier 5s and it was just way more enjoyable and way easier. Now pay attention how all enemies are going to get spotted, and Klurkstai spotted all of them because of this ability. And this ability is look, those sniper schnitzels over there, they can shit on them, and Artist Strike simply eliminated all of them immediately like this. Do I think this game mode is a good idea? Yes. As wrong as it sounds, fellas, to have player versus bots mode is not bad. I mean, it's definitely not bad. You can have some fun, and if everything is going bad in the randoms or something, you know, there is those days when you cannot do shit. So if it's that day, I can tell you very, very simple thing. This game mode can be a good option, right? But once again, what they did right there, it's kind of stupid. What do I mean by saying that? It's very, very simple thing when I'm saying stupid. First of all, fuel. I don't know what they was smoking while they was thinking the fuel is a good option for this game mode, because I have no clue. Why am I saying that? Well, answer is extremely simple right there. I am saying that because it's not a Candy Crush for obvious reasons, and this is, I can tell you that this is going to be the last video which I'm going to make for this game mode, unless Wargaming is going to change it. I will play it from time to time with my clan mates. Maybe I will be able to get myself the, how it's called, the extra rations or whatever, the improved equipment and so on, but you know, it is a lot of work, let's say like that. You know what, I have an idea. We can actually run with a, actually it's not looking very good. I was thinking we can run with a double speed right here, but no, it's not the case. Anyways, pay attention to what we are doing right here and how everything is looking like in this battle. So we have the perfect crossfire right here. And those four guys, as you can see, all of us are in the team speak, and we are saying focus this, bomb this, do this, do this, and so on. We are talking, and Cover 1S is not in the team speak, but he played extremely well, so for obvious reasons I am not complaining about this at all. Also one more thing which I definitely wanted to say, and probably I did not finish it saying. So if you want to get yourself bigger tier vehicle, right, what that basically means, you need to play shitload of battles or you need to pay gold. I paid gold. I am disgusting person, how dare I did this, because I wanted to get myself, you know what, how it's called, I wanted to get myself credit boosters. That's what I wanted to get for myself. Anyways, it doesn't matter. 5 waves left, easy peasy, just like this, and look how we are going to spot them in 5, 4, all of them is getting spotted. This ability is sick. This ability is insanely good, and I am having, let's say like that, I'm having quite some time, quite some fun time while using it and while playing this. I mean, I thought it's going to be worse than it was, to be honest, because first impressions was very first impressions of mine was, you know, it was not funny, and believe me, it's not when you are playing against the in the random. So what kind of experience did I had when I played against when I was alone and I clicked into the battle, when I played with the 5 random guys while we are not chilling in the TeamSpeak or Discord or whatever, you get the point what I'm saying, right? So what was happening? Usually I was at the tier 3, 3 guys was a tier 1, and the 5th guy was like a tier 2 or tier 3. And what is happening? When we are getting the wave with the leopards, which is a wave number 8 if I'm not mistaken, all our team is taking one for the team, and it's pretty much GG, finito, it's just bad. The Stuk hit me right there, that was greediness from my side. And I have no rights to complain about that, right? 5 waves left, actually we survived at 5, yes, 5 waves left. And let's try to win this, by the way, that was only one, this is the best battle which we ever had. Out of 6 games, and majority of the battles we used to lose on the wave 10 or wave 9 or wave 8. Once again, why that kind of stuff happened? It happened probably because we did not have too much experience, and on the same time it happened because it simply happened because our teammates was not a level 3 and we was playing against the level 3 opponents, right? Which I believe makes sense. Anyways, no complaints, no regrets. We are just enjoying ourselves. We are doing some spotting right there. And we are doing quite some damage. And look, now those tier 3s, they are having so much fun while sniping everyone over there. It's crazy. I'm so lucky this Panzer actually missed me. And you know, it can be funny. I can imagine this mode being very, very good. Only couple of changes needs to be made. Maybe selection of the easy hard mode or whatever, or medium mode, and obviously removing the fucking idiotic system of the fuel. That's it, finito. This game mode can actually be decent, and to have an events from time to time like this, it's not that terrible. One more thing which I definitely want to highlight, Wargaming, don't push people to play that much in order to get rewards. For example, have you seen your frontline gaming experience, how much you need to play in order to get a tier 9 tank? I mean, what the F you are smoking? You know how much you need to grind that shitty ass game mode, which is boring, which is disgusting, and majority of the people don't like it, but some people love it. Yes, I completely understand that. Anyways, In this game mode, fellas, I can tell you that. Plus, one more thing which is very, very important. Majority of the people won't be able to take the 2 improved equipments. It doesn't matter how much you are willing to play the... how it's called? The fuel system is ruining everything, and it doesn't matter what you are doing. It's going to, if you are, especially if you are playing in the randoms, right, so you are playing together with a shitload of guys which you don't know, and so on, it might be very sad, very bad, and it's not going to be the most enjoyable gaming experience. You will lose majority of the battles, and you know, it's not going to be very, very fun. I believe you get the point what I'm saying right there. Anyways, fellas, Tiger 1 went in front right here. We need to win the 4 battles, and oh boy, Tiger is enjoying himself while Waves is simply While our planes are simply shitting on him, as you can see. So we need to survive 3 more waves, because this one, let's get real, it's already done. Our Inni died for Tiger, probably he managed to spot him somehow, but it is how it is, no complaints, right? So 3 hardest waves left. How we are going to survive this? Because those ones before, it's not that important. Now I will try to explain what we was doing, at least in this map, and how everything worked for us. And I believe if you paid attention at the screen all the time, you notice that I'm trying to take the ammunition all the time. So our sniper Schnitzels is not going to be out of the ammunition, which is completely understandable, right? So now look, what is happening right here? I'm taking safer defense parameter because Leotards will go very, very aggressively. The tier 5 shitters, right? So they will get spotted in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All of them is getting spotted, and now the pretty much most important thing is to launch the air strikes and to try to get as much use as we can, right? This is one of the hardest waves, by the way, because those guys have quite good speed, and you need to spot them very, very early if you want to deal with them. And one of the more important things, as wrong as it sounds, if you are playing with a friend, right, make sure one of you will have this ability, which I do, which is completely overpowered, to spot enemies for like 15 or 20 seconds. It doesn't matter where are they, right? So this ability is just solid banana out of 10, and it's working extremely, extremely well. So far so good. No one crossed through. We lost only one tank right here. We have 7,000 damage, which is low, but we have 11,000 assisting damage, which we gathered with this Arte strike, or however you are calling that, planes which spotted all enemies, right? So yeah, 2 more waves left. Now Panthers, and if I'm not mistaken, Panther with the Tigers, right? So what we are going to do, we are not immediately launching this, we are waiting until the very first Panther will get spotted. And whenever the first Panther, actually I think I will launch that now. Yes, I did that because I was afraid our cover 1S might take one for the team and it's going to be bad. So we are running, we are launching more Arte strikes right there just to help our guy to finish with those people, with those bots which is moving in front. And tell us, accuracy of the bots is, oh boy, oh boy, accuracy of the bots is insanely good, okay? And question is, maybe we will be able to survive this battle with only one tank? What do you think, fellas? Is it possible? We'll see. Anyways, the Panther, only 4 Panthers left right there, and all our team needs to do, our team needs to snipe them, and everything is going to be Gucci. Obviously, I noticed this Panther over there, right? I definitely noticed that, but you know what is the shittest thing of all this? Yep. The bot went in front and he killed me. So now the life is going to be 17 times harder. Why so? The most important thing why it's going to be way harder is we don't have that sorry fellas, we don't have that ability to spot them, that plane or however you are calling that. That's what that's it, finito. So all we need to do now, we need to wait until our people is going to deal with a Pantera. So I'm making twice faster speed right here, and the last wave out of the enemy side. So 3 Tigers, Panther, Tiger, Panther, Tiger, Panther. So what we are doing right here, we are thinking about going a bit more aggressive over there, and maybe we can do some early shots. So first victim right here, the Panther. We are launching the Art of Strike. Panther is taking one for the team. Meanwhile, our Sniper Schnitzel is simply fapping on the people, which is getting spotted. I'm launching the super abilities, or however you are calling that, Art of Strikes and so on, and we are trying to run for our life. Why we are running for our life? Because we don't want to get murdered. If the bots will get close to you, you are pretty much dead and no one can save your soul. And this is definitely one of the most important things right there. So what we are going to do now? Now we are fapping next to the red line and we are having so much fun while doing so. Eliminating them one by one and simply trying to get as much use of all this. Now, fellas, whoops, I clicked the wrong button. You did not notice it yet, okay? Stop it. Stop it. You never notice it. Quick conclusion, fellas, we won this game out. Amazing gaming experience, everything is fine, no bugs whatsoever. Good job, our gaming. Keep up the good job. It's just beautiful, it's just amazing, it's just Alt F4. Thank you so much for watching, fellas. My opinion is very simple, like I mentioned it before. It could be good, but the greed from Wargaming side is winning all the time, and you know, let's milk our players, which is idiotic in my opinion. But once again, Wargaming is the company and companies need to make money, right? So it's understandable. So once again, quick information about everything. Tomorrow, fellas, I'm not sure are we going to have video tomorrow. If you did not enjoy this one, I apologize. Not much what I can do about this. And now I'm bringing my PC to the computer specialist and they're going to fix everything. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time. Peace.